My orientation will be green in front, white on top. And this one will be my buffer sticker. You can find all the scrambles down in the description box. So let us start by taking a look at where this piece needs to go. This is the green and orange piece. So your first step needs to be that you need to find the respective centers. In this case, the green and orange centers. So I can see that I have my green center right here and my orange center right here. Now take a look at where the bottom sticker, that is this sticker, needs to go. Should it go right here or should it go right here? So the correct answer would be right here. And according to the SPEF's lettering scheme, that is the letter L. If for some reason you did memorize it in the letter F, you would end up with a piece that is flipped over here and your cube would not be solved. That is why it is really important that you need to know where the piece needs to go, and not just that, but in which orientation does it need to go. So going back to our example, this needs to go to the letter L. And as you can see, this piece needs to go over here, but that is a buffer piece. And if you have reached a buffer piece, we need to stop memorizing the cycle. Now we need to break into a new cycle. Basically, all it means is that you now need to select a piece which we have not yet been to. So except the letter L, in this case, we have not been to any other piece. So you can start off with any other piece. For this example, I'll choose the letter B. Also, the reason why we don't memorize this piece going back over here, that is the letter U, is because we have ended our cycle and we need not memorize it. But when we start a new cycle, we need to start and stop at the same piece. So now that I started at B, I either need to come back to B or back to M, and only then can I say that I've completed the new cycle. So this letter goes over here, that is the letter N. This goes over here, that is the letter S. But since S is second in the letter pair, I'll be switching it over to I instead. This piece needs to go over here, that is the letter V. This one needs to go back over here, and that is the letter B. And because we started and stopped at the same piece, not necessarily the same sticker, we need to stop memorizing this cycle and break into another cycle. So choose any piece that we have not yet been to. For simplicity, I'll just be choosing the letter D. This goes over here, that is the letter Q. This piece needs to go right here, that is the letter X. This goes over here, that is the letter C. But since C is again second in the letter pair, I'll be switching over to W instead. This piece needs to go over here, that is the letter H. And this needs to go back over here, that is the letter D. And since we have again reached back to where we started our new cycle from, we stop memorizing. And now that we have been to all the edges, we can stop memorizing for the edges. So our final list for edges would be like this. So now let's go into the execution part. You can find a list of all the setup moves down in the description box as well. So we needed to get our buffer to L, so we can get L to the target location by doing like this. Now we can do an M2 to swap and restore all the setup moves. Next, we need to break into a new cycle, and we had started with the letter B, so I need to get B to the target location. And now instead of doing the standard M2, that is using the ring finger and the middle finger, there's a much more better way that you should be doing M2 instead. This is also a way lot faster. So it goes something like this. So all we are trying to do is we are doing an R prime and R wide, and now we can use our ring finger only to do a slice M. So this basically achieves the same thing. It does M2, but it is way faster as your fingers are already in the home position. Due to this, we'll have far less regrips in our solve. And now we can undo our setup moves. Next, we have to go to the letter N. Now there are two different ways of getting N to the target location. One is using the wide moves and the other one is not using the wide moves. I personally prefer doing it with the wide moves, so that is what I'll be doing in this example solve as well. So I can set N to the target location by doing like this, do a M2 to swap, and now restore the setup moves. Next, we have the letter I, and for this you need to know an algorithm. Next, we have VB. And now the letter B. Next, we have D. Next, we have the letter Q. And again, for this, you need to know an algorithm. Next, we have the letter X. Then we have the letter W. Next, we have the letter H. And lastly, we have the letter D. For the corners, you can use old Pockman or any other method you know to solve the corners, but because M2 is mainly related to the edges, that is what I'll be showing you in this video. This is the second scramble, you can find it in the description box, and again I'll be holding green in front, white on top. So this is my buffer sticker, this goes over here, that is the letter I, and since this is the piece that goes back to the buffer, we stop our cycle and take a new piece which we have not yet been to. Again, let's start off by taking the letter B. This goes over here, that is the letter F, which goes over here, that is the letter Q. This one needs to go right here, that is the letter W. This goes over here, that is the letter X. This goes over here, that is the letter N. This goes over here, that is the letter M. And now since we have reached M, which is the same piece from where we started our new cycle, that is the letter B, we need to stop memorizing this cycle as well and break into another new cycle. So again, for simplicity, I'll be choosing the letter D. This goes over here, that is the letter O. And this goes back over here, that is the letter D. So since we have again reached the same piece, we need to start another new cycle. We have not yet been to this piece, so we can start by taking the letter P. This one needs to go right here, that is the letter R. And this goes right here, that is the letter J. There may be some of you who are feeling, why didn't I start the new cycle with the letter J and I rather started with P? Well, there's no specific reason behind that. It all comes down to your personal preference. Doing J would be smarter because it requires far less regrips and it's almost like you don't do any more regrips at all. But as you see, I started with P, I went to R, and now I'm ending my cycle at J. So if I started my cycle with J in this case, I would go to the other sticker of the same piece. So since this is R, I would actually go over here, that is the letter H. And then this would go over here, that is the letter P. So that barely makes any difference. That is why in this case, I decided to start off with whichever came to my mind first, rather than thinking which would be easy to set up and which would not be. So now back to the execution part. First was the letter I, and this requires an algorithm. Next, we have the letter B. Then we have the letter F. Next we have the letter Q. Then we have the letter W. Next we have the letter X. Then we have the letter N. Next we have the letter M. Then we have the letter D. Next is O. Then we go back to D. Then we have the letter P. Next is the letter R. And finally the letter J. So as you saw in both the examples, we had no parity, and you can only get a parity if you remember an odd number of edges. This is how a cube would look if you ended with a parity. So how do you fix this parity case? There's a really simple algorithm which goes like this. So basically what it does is it does a M2 and it also swaps these two edges right here. I hope these example solves helped clarify some of your doubts you probably had in the M2 method. Also, you can find some more videos related to blind solving here at the end screen. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please subscribe if you're new to my channel and like the video if you haven't already. Take care of yourselves, guys, and have an amazing time ahead.